Well, it's been quite a few months since I did a last video, and the last one was about autumn and the autumn season of human life. Today I'm, you can see in the background, today I'm at Loxahatchee National Wildlife Refuge in southern Florida on the Cypress Swamp boardwalk. It's interesting. Florida's an interesting place. It's certainly a bird photography mecca. You've got tremendous diversity of birds down here, and there's a strange connection between humans and birds down here. There's a lot of close contact between birds and human beings, and I think that there's some positive lessons to learn here about Florida, and maybe some negative lessons. Recently, there was an article talking about how important species diversity is for the health of the environment, and also how when there's more species of birds together, they sometimes help each other. Up north in Pennsylvania, where I live, of course, in the wintertime, you don't see many birds, but you'll come across flocks of birds like titmice and nuthatches and chickadees. And what they found is these birds tend to cluster in flocks because they help each other. The diversity of the species, each one has different skills and abilities. And one of the things that I like about South Florida is there is a tremendous diversity of birds down here. There's a lot of water birds. And in a place like this Cypress Swamp here at Loxahatchee National Wildlife Refuge, I just saw a few species of birds that I won't see up in Pennsylvania for another couple of months. Blue-headed vireo, northern parula warbler. You can hear some blue jays flying over right now. And what is interesting about Florida that I'm observing here, because I don't come down here that much, is, how can I put it, the segregation of different types of people down here. On the way up Route 441 to Loxahatchee, I looked on the right and there's a huge development of luxury retirement villas, homes in there, and it said starting at $900,000. And one of the things I've noticed about Florida here, South Florida, is the wealth is just unbelievable. I'm not sure what that has to do with diversity of human beings down here, but I do know that a lot of people come down here in the winter because it's too cold up north and the energy down here is good. It's warmer. It's the climate's more favorable. And of course, when I come down south here, I see the birds that would be up north in the spring and summer, and they spend the winter down here too. One of the other things I like about coming to Florida as I travel is that when you travel, I don't know if you've noticed, there's certain smells of places that the only way you can get that smell is by being in that place. Same thing with certain foods too, and certain natural ingredients. That holistic experience of life, I think, is very important. And as we get into the winter season of life, old age, sometimes our senses are diminished. I work in geriatric care, so I see people whose vision and maybe taste and smell is beginning to wane. But that's no reason to stop appreciating the diversity of things in our environment, whether it be human environment with food or culture or the natural environment. When I look at the winter season of life, we can think of that as old age or very old age. Each season doesn't mean life is over. It means, as I said in my prior video, that the energy is different. And as we have less energy and are more energy sensitive in the winter season of life, we need to invest in relationships and activities where we are receiving some energy back in the things that we do. Are we in relationships that eat up energy but don't give us any energy back? Are we giving something on as our legacy so that the energy we are passing on to younger people is not just youthfulness, beauty, or athletic prowess, but wisdom and finding meaning in life? So as I continue to walk through the Cypress Swamp here, I hear some blue-gray gnat catchers. I'll be heading over a little bit later to the Everglades side, maybe see some alligators and various water birds. And remember, in the winter season of life, don't forget to pack or put diversity into your life with activities, with all your senses, social activities. Watch your energy and conserve your energy. Get energy from good relationships and pass along good energy to other people.